2 years ago, I bought a new video screen for my home theater. It's a Panasonic ZT60, 60-inch display. I put it in my office on a table and found that it encroached on my desk space a little bit too much. So I resolved that I would build my own speakers that were as narrow as they possibly could be to go with my screen and to integrate then the speakers with the screen so that the screen serves as an extension of the baffle of the speaker. So what you see here is a mock television screen that's the exact size of the one that I have, with the bezel the right size, and how I've designed the speakers to mate with it, even to the point of having the tweeter array overlap the bezel so that the screen serves as an extension of the baffle. So this is a very wide baffle design. In order to get as narrow a box as possible, I watched Parts Express, and on buyout, they offered these 4.5-inch tang band woofers. So I just calculated the distance from the table to the ceiling and how tall a box I could possibly make and how many woofers I could cram into it, and it turned out to be 12. So that's how many I ordered, and that's how I built this. When I'm listening to it, it's usually by myself or maybe with two more people, so I only need wide enough dispersion to handle three seats about 2 meters away. So any wider dispersion, I don't care about. I had a little bit of difficulty choosing the mid-tweeter. I had these are Dayton, nominally 1 1/8-inch wide-range mini speakers. I had these to build for a computer monitor that I was going to put the speakers on either side of the computer monitor screen. I decided to use them here instead. And there was some challenge getting the holes cut precisely for a press fit design and in line. I used this jig I built to try to use a router to cut those holes in very precise fashion. After some experimentation, I gave up on this. I might have been able to make it work eventually. I switched instead to this. This is an adjustable width bit. where you can make it precisely the design you want, and you can sharpen the edge, and with a sharp edge, it makes a very clean hole. And the muscle power required to drive this is probably no more than the muscle power required to handle a big router. Yeah. Now, the crossover here, the manufacturer said these will go up to 3,000, and the manufacturer said these will go down to 300. So that gave me about a decade during which I could place a crossover somewhere. I decided to let these little ones run full range. They naturally roll off in the 300s, 315, 350. And so I put one cap on them to steepen the roll-off below their natural roll-off, but not to limit their bandwidth any. So these are running their full bandwidth. Now that means they're running from about 350 all the way up to 16,000, which is 5.5 octaves on this driver array. So the crossover is about 350, as I said. In order to get the woofers to cross over at that point, these are high inductance woofers. They needed some kind of impedance control for any kind of a passive crossover to work at all. I just used a shunt resistor. That was enough with one coil, and that got the roll-off that I needed for the crossover. These naturally are rolling off below about 140 on the low end. So from 140 to 400 or so is only about an octave and a half being borne by the woofers. There's some obstruction with these tweeters in front of a couple of the woofers that might worry some people. It doesn't worry me, because below 400 hertz, wavelengths are at least 34 inches long. And a 34-inch wave is going to find its way around this few-inch obstruction without too much difficulty. And these other woofers are also behaving more or less omnidirectionally anyway, so they're spreading their sound left and right in every which way. So to direct this sound out to the left and to the right isn't going to do that much damage. There might be a little diffraction effect, but not much. So I just don't worry about the obstruction issue. These wings are designed to limit horizontal dispersion. So if you were sitting outside this angle, you might not hear the full range. But even more important, these have extremely limited vertical dispersion. That they are up to spec really only within the band represented by this black band. I feel sort of like Mickey Mouse at Disney World saying, you have to be this tall to ride this ride. Right? If you're not this tall, it's not going to work. But also, if you're taller than this, it's not going to work either. The high frequency falls off quite dramatically if you listen to it above that. So that's a very narrow band to listen to, but since I always listen to it sitting in the same chair anyway, that's okay. Now, if you look very closely around the tweeters, there's a little bit of texture to the baffle. According to a white paper by Johnson and Linden, they were talking about the Baynes effect of wave propagation, and that for about an octave around the Baynes frequency, if the baffle around a tweeter is a little bit, is too smooth, too absolutely smooth, it bothers the fabulation of the wave propagation. So with the too smooth baffle, you get defabbed waves, and so there's a little texture there, just enough to increase the frequency of confabulation.